How are you? I hope you all are fine and safe at home. Students, I welcome all of you to a new session of maths. I hope that you all have watched the first video which was sent earlier. It was about the first lesson, a fish tail. A part of the first lesson was explained in that video. Today I am going to explain the place value chart. I know you have all learned about the place value chart in the lower classes. But if you learn it very clearly, it will help you to read and write the numbers, even the bigger numbers, 6-digit or 7-digit numbers, very easily if you know the place value chart. The place value chart begins with the ones place at the extreme right. And the place value chart, remember, it starts from the right to left. To the extreme right is ones place. Then moving to the left, tens, hundreds, thousands, ten thousands, lakhs, 10 lakhs, crores, and 10 crores. So remember, it is started from the right to left. Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, ten thousands, lakhs, 10 lakhs, crores, and 10 crores are the various places in the place value chart. And this place value chart is also divided into 4 periods. The first period is called the ones period. Second period is the thousands period. Third period is the lakhs period. And fourth period, the crores. The first period, the ones period, consists of, it includes 3 digits. 3 digit means ones place, tens place, and 100 place are included in the ones period. Now the next is the thousands period. It includes thousands and 10 thousands. That means only 2 digits are included in thousands period. Now moving to the next day, in the lakhs period also there are 2 digits, that is lakhs and 10 lakhs. The last period is the crores period. It includes crores and 10 crores. That means it also includes only 2 digits. Remember, only the first period, that is the ones period, includes 3 digits, ones place, tens place, and 100 place. Remaining periods contain only 2 digits. Now, I will show you how to name the numbers, even the bigger numbers. This lesson you have to learn the numbers up to lakhs place. That means 6 digit numbers you have to learn. And how to name the bigger numbers, I will show you with an example. It's a 6-digit number. Before trying to read the number, first you have to place the comma in the correct place. Placing comma means first comma will be coming after the first period. First period means the ones period. After 3 digits, ones, tens, hundreds, then comma. The second comma comes after the second period, that is the thousands periods. Thousands and 10,000, then lakhs. So we will divide it into 3 periods. Ones period, thousands period, and lakhs period. Now, it will be very easy for you to read the number. How many lakhs? 3 lakhs. And both the digits in the thousands period you have to read together. How many thousands? 25,000. Now, the remaining three digits in the ones place, or means ones period, we have to read together. How many ones? 241. 241. So, this written number, the given number is 3,25,241. Let me show some more examples. Second number. Here also first you have to place the comma in the correct place. First comma comes after the first period of 3 digits. 1, 10, 100. then 1,000, 10,000 together, then the last year lakhs period. So it is lakhs, thousand, ones. What is the digit of the lakhs place? 4. So it will be 4 lakh. How many thousands? 0, 7. We don't have to mention 0. We will write only 7,000. 4 lakh 7,000. How many ones? 592. So remember, if anywhere 0 comes in between, we don't have to read as 0, 7. We will read only it as 7. So the given number is 4,7,592. Now the next example. You try to read it. First you have to place the comma. First comma comes after this place. Once you know one period, second comma comes after thousands period. So it will be 8 lakh. What are the digits in the thousands place? 0. So we are not going to read 0, 0. We will take only it as 8,205. Now we show one more example. So the first work will be placing comma in the correct position. So first comma comes after 3 digits. Now after every 2 digits. How many lakhs? 5 lakh. How many thousand? 23,000. And one period contained here only 8. So this number can be read as 5,23,008. And students, I hope you have understood this portion. Now I am going to solve and show some questions from the textbook. The fish brought in all by each type of boat in 7 rigs, and the quantity of fish brought in 1 rupees given. If the log boat, first we will consider the log boat. The log boat brings 20 kilogram of fish in 1 rig. And how much fish will be brought in? 7 ribs. So we will multiply this quantity of fish brought in 1 rig by 7. So I will show you the easy method of multiplication. Instead of multiplying 20 into 7, we will multiply all multiplication we will do. 2 sevens are 14. 2 into 7. 2 sevens are 14. And we will also add the 0. So 240 kilogram of fish will be brought by the log boat in 7 trips. Next is the long tail boat. Long tail boat. And how much fish it brings in 1 trip? It brings 600 kilogram of fish in 1 trip. So in 7 rib is equal to 600 kilogram multiplied by 7. Here also we will follow the easy multiplication. All calculation only 6 sevens are 42. 42, and also we will add the 2 zeros. So 4200 kilogram of the fish will be brought in 7 ribs. And next we will move to the next boat. That is the motor boat. How much fish is brought by the motor boat in 1 trip? 800 kilogram. So 800 kilogram it will multiply by 7. 8 7 56, and also we will add the 2 0. So 5600 kilogram of fish will be brought in 7 trips by the motor boat, and the last one, the machine boat. The machine boat brings 6000 kilogram of fish in 1 trip. So in 7 trips, 6000 multiply by 7. So 6 sevens are 42. How many zeros you add? 3 zeros. That means 42,000 kilogram of fish will be brought by the machine boat in 7 trips. Students, now we will see the second question. The second question is about how far can a motor boat go in 6 hours. How far means how much distance the motor boat can cover in 6 hours. The speed of the motor boat in 1 hour is given. Speed means distance a vehicle travels in 1 hour. This is another speed of the vehicle. So speed of the motor boat is 20 km per hour. That means the motor boat moves or travels 20 km in 1 hour. So our question is how much distance it will cover in 6 hours if it moves at the speed of 20 km per 1 hour. So you should learn this formula. Distance is equal to speed multiplied by time. So distance is equal to speed into time. What is the speed of the boat? Speed of the boat is 20 km per hour. And how much time it is taking? 6 hours it takes. So 20 into 6 is 120 km it travels in 6 hours. Have you understood? Distance is equal to speed into time. So speed is 20 km and we have to find out the distance it covers in 6 hours. So 20 into 6, that is 120 km will be moved or travelled by or covered by the motor boat in 6 hours. Now the next question is, if a long tail boat has to travel 60 km, how long will it take? Now next question is, if the long tail boat has to travel 60 km, how much distance it has to travel? 60 km it has to travel. And what is the speed of the long tail boat? The speed of the long tail boat is 12 km/h. And we have to find out how much time it will take it to cover 60 km. That means we have to find out the time taken by the long tail boat. So time is equal to distance dividing by speed. This formula also children you have to learn. Time is equal to distance covered by speed. So how much distance it is covering? It has to cover 60 km. What is the speed of the boat? The speed of the boat is 12 km/h. So 60 divided by 12 is equal to 5. So it will take 5 hours to cover 60 km. Students, I hope you have understood the portion I explained today. The remaining part will be explaining in the next session. Thank you all. Be indoors. Be safe.